basic.
I'm so fancy. You already know I'm in the fast lane. From LA to Tokyo. I'm so fancy. Can't you taste this?
Well, I feel really fancy because I'm putting on my opal jewelry, and you will see what this has to do with the story here in a little bit, but it's like my favorite. So let's go ahead and hop in to Porpoises in Peril. We are on lesson 6 already. Can you believe it, guys? I sure can't. And we are going to be focusing on, we're learning to analyze the structure of the text to understand what is happening in the story. We will be successful when we can identify the structure of the text, complete the graphic organizer, and describe what happens in the text. First, I'm kind of going to help you because we did this in the last lesson. We already know what the structure is. We know that the structure is sequence. We're telling a story, so it's going to be in order. So together, we're going to draw this graphic organizer, and we're going to start up at the top with our title. We are obviously reading Porpoises in Peril, so I'm going to put that up at the top of mine. I hope you haven't already, grab a piece of paper and a pencil and be doing this with me. Porpoises in Peril is up at the top. Then we have our characters. I'm not going to list all of them out. I can easily just say members of the science squad. I'm going to put that in my character box. Members of the science squad. Now, what will be the setting of this chapter? We don't know yet, so I'm not going to put that. I am going to put at the top that this will be the setting box because we're going to figure that out when we get to reading. Then I am going to go ahead and just draw 1, 2. Oh my goodness, I'm not going to leave enough room. 3 and 4 boxes. Not my best work. Just try your best. We'll do with what we can. So once you're done drawing out your graphic organizer to have ready when we're reading, we're gonna set that to the side and go ahead and pause if you need more time. And if not, we're gonna keep going. So we are starting a new foundational skill today. You've been working on ing and ed, adding those to different words to change the tense. Now we're focusing on adding different suffixes. If you add ER to the end of the word, to a base word, you're comparing two places, people, or things. If you're adding EST to the end of the word, you're comparing more than two people or things. So let's look into what this means. So the team listened intently as Jada continued. And we also got a tip about bright lights on the water more recently, late at night, the crab shack owner had. So I noticed two words in here that we could add ER or EST to. Did you notice them? Well, the first one I noticed was bright, because we could change that word, or late. You can change both of those words. So bright could be changed to brighter or brightest. So if you think about that, can we use that word in a sentence? My shirt was brighter than Miss Wager's shirt. You're only comparing my shirt and Miss Wager's shirt. That's two things. But if we wanted to use brightest, the star was the brightest in the whole sky. So you're comparing that star to every star in the sky. So that's more than two things. So now my question for you is, can you use later and latest in a sentence? Pause here if you need more time. We're going to go ahead and move on to vocabulary today. That is what your assignment is going to be on in Seesaw. The first word you can choose from is scamming. And I put that little picture at the bottom, a scam alert. So the sentence from the text is, he is wanted for scamming people out of their money through a company called Drake Darkly Jewels. He called himself a miner and sold worthless silver mines. So do you know what scamming means? See if you can figure it out before I show it. Scamming means you deceive someone, especially when the goal is to take the person's money. So were you right? The next vocabulary word is precious. And we got all those pretty jewels, kind of like with my opals. It was about an underwater mine worth billions, not millions, billions. The mine was supposed to be full of precious opals, but she never had anything to show for it. Not one single opal. So what do you think precious means? Precious means rare and worth a lot of money. Is that what you guessed? All right, guys. So you're going to take this time when you're done with the video to do this table that we've been working on with either you can choose precious or scamming. And you're going to do the definitions, synonyms, antonyms, a sentence, and a picture, just like we've been doing. You might have it in Seesaw or just a piece of paper and a pencil. Let's go ahead and start chapter 4. That evening, the science squad met in Jada's room to report their findings. Oop, ding, 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 I found a setting. So I'm going to pause and I'm going to put that in our settings box. We're in Jada's room. All right. That evening, the science squad met in Jada's room to report their findings. Cam and Jada filled in Kate and Reggie on the interview they had conducted with the fishermen. As they ran through the part about the barge, Cam mentioned the DDJ initials the fishermen had seen on the side of the barge. DDJ. DDJ, Kate muttered. Where have I seen that before? Wait! The rest of the science squad turned to look at Kate. I saw it this morning, she continued. That rude man who stole our taxi, his briefcase said DDJ on the side. I'm sure of it. Kim interrupted her. In the crab shack, I smelled that odd smell again, a sort of citrus and cedar smell. You went to the crab shack without us? Said Kate, disappointed. Hang on, said Jada. What about those photos I took at the crab shack? Maybe we should take a look at them. Kim, pass me your laptop. Jada quickly uploaded the pictures and began flicking through them one by one, looking at them carefully. Suddenly, she spotted something. Look, there, she cried to the rest of the team. The team peered over her shoulder, and there in the background of her photo was the man from the taxi holding his briefcase. Sure enough, it had the letters DDJ on the side of it. Jada zoomed in and studied the man's picture closely. Think I'll use my picture recognition software to find out who this guy is, she said. Oop, we got a stop sign. So stop this page we're going to focus on. What events allow the science squad to discover the meaning of DDJ on the side of the barge? It only took a few minutes before Jada had a name. His name, at least his current one, is Drake Darkly. He's well known in the precious gems business. And not in a good way. He is wanted for scamming people out of their money through a company called Drake Darkly Jewels. He called himself a miner and sold worthless silver mines. He's believable because he has a degree in mining engineering, she said. Drake Darkly Jewels, said Cam. Hang on, DDJ. So we found out the meaning of DDJ, but how did they get there? So let's think. This is kind of the sequence of this whole chapter because we're about done with this chapter. Ooh, so let's use this as our sequence. What are the steps that they take to find out what DDJ means? Well, the first thing that we notice is, well, Cam mentioned DDJ, but what is the first thing Kate remembers seeing the initials DDJ? So that's the first event I'm going to write down. Kate remembers seeing the initials DDJ. Then What is the next step that they take? Cam interrupted. You're the crab shack without us. Hang on, Jada said. What about those pictures? So the next step is Jada looks through her pictures. Jada looks through her pictures. And she actually finds one with him in it, right? Then, what do they do with that picture once they find it? I think I'll use my picture recognition software. So then, Jada uses their software. I haven't shown this to you yet. So the first one, we put Kate remembers seeing the initials DDJ. Then Jada looks through her pictures. And then if I had more room, I would put, and she found a picture of him. Then down here, I'm going to put this part with the arrow. I'm going to put, I think I'll use my picture recognition software. So Jada uses picture recognition software. Oh boy. Then what is the next step after they do? Well, obviously in that step with the software to figure out what his name is, to recognize, to identify, let's do that word, to identify Drake Darkly. Then that last step is that connection that they make right here. It says, Cam said it. You know, he runs Drake Darkly Jewels, and that stands for DDJ. So, his name, at least his current one, is Drake Darkly. He's well known in her precious gems business, and not in a good way. He's wanted for scamming people. Hang on, DDJ. What else do they say? That would make sense, said Reggie, and the mining information fits with my water analysis. I found ocean bed sediment in water hundreds of feet above the seabed, which would fit with mining activity. That would certainly explain where all the fish have gone. So Reggie connects. Darkly's mining with the water. And guys, we just used sequence to help us figure out how the science squad solved their problem. This is all the steps they took to figure out the answer to that problem. Pretty cool stuff. To discover what the DDJ on the side of the barge meant. Super cool. So, let's keep reading. That would certainly explain where all the fish have gone. And look at these pictures, Kate said, showing the team the pictures of the structure she'd seen while diving. I know it's fuzzy and it's from the area where the barge supposedly lost power. I bet that it's mining equipment. Come to think of it, Cam and I heard an interesting story when we ate at the crab shack, Jada said. Interesting, Cam said. I think it was more like someone was yanking your chain. Do you know what yanking your chain means? It means they're like pulling your leg. They're both kind of sayings for when they're kind of tricking you. Come on, buddy. Oh my goodness. Technical difficulty. For years, Jada began ignoring Cam. A lady in the town told a story to anyone who would listen. It was about an underwater mine worth billions, not millions. Billions. The mine was supposed to be full of precious opals, but she never had anything to show for it. Not one single opal. Then she just disappeared. The team listened intently as Jada continued, and we also got a tip about bright lights on the water. More recently, late at night, the crab shack owner had seen the lights a couple of times while he was locking up for the night. Well, it sounds like we've got our guy, said Cam. Drake Darkly, illegal jewel miner, and ocean polluter. But what now? Now we prove it, said Kate, gathering her things. So now you see why I dressed up in my opals today, because they're talking about opals. So guys, this is the coolest thing. We actually already did this. When we talked about the plot of chapter 4, when we made this sequence chart, we basically figured out the structure is a sequence. It's in chronological order. Those are synonyms. They're kind of the same. And the plot was that the science squad met in Jada's room, and they were able to make the connection that DDJ is Drake Darkly Jewels. And yeah, just like that, this all connects, and you could easily tell somebody if they came up and was like, hey, what was chapter 4 about? Be like, well, actually, Kate remembered seeing the initial, and you could just go through your chart and tell them. So super cool. Next, it's your turn. So it's time for the reading response. What important discoveries do the science squad members make when they meet in Jada's room to report their findings? So we kind of went through most of them, but what do you think is the most important discoveries that they made together? So you can go on Seesaw, or you can, with your piece of paper and pencil, write down the answer to this question. And thank you so much for coming prepared to class today, guys. We'll see you next time. Bye.